Steve Dotto here. How the heck are you this fine day? Me? Well, my bags are packed and I'm ready to go. I'm heading off on another business trip. Now, it used to be that when I headed off on travel, I used to really enjoy the time on the airplane because it gave me time to sit down and write without any distractions, to open my notebook computer and do some writing. Well, that doesn't happen anymore because the seats are so darn small, it's too cramped. I just don't feel comfortable writing anymore. So instead now what I do when I'm traveling is I recapture that time and I use it to read all of the little bits of information that I haven't had time to consume over the past little while. And to facilitate that, I use a tool called Pocket. Pocket allows me to clip all of the different articles and posts that I want to have a look at later and store them for offline browsing when I have the time, specifically in my case, when I'm traveling. Now, I know a lot of you are saying, wait a minute, Steve, you've shown us how to do similar things in Evernote. Yes, you can do similar things in Evernote, but Pocket works better for this particular purpose, for clipping informational articles that you're interested in reading at a later point and then delivering those to you wherever and whenever you happen to want to consume them. And so that is what we're going to be looking at today on Dotto Tech. Pocket is a free app. You can buy a premium version that includes some extra bells and whistles and bigger storage and longer term storage and that sort of stuff. But you can try it out with the free version and get a really good feel for everything it will do. Let me show you how it kind of fits in your life. Let's say that you're browsing along at a typical website. Now, I go to Social Media Examiner on a day, pretty much daily basis. I read a lot of the articles right away, but some of the articles I say, wow, I want to spend some time and think about this one and maybe even store it for future research and or read it later. So here's a typical one. Analyzing my content with Google Analytics. Huh? That's something I'm not going to understand in just a few seconds. Are you? So here I'm going to, instead of just reading the article now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to save it to Pocket so that I can read it or reference it at a later point. And how I do that is as simple as can be. Into my browser, I've installed the Pocket Clipper. I just click on that. And it allows me to add tags, which allows me to do search later. If you use this a lot, you might want to be classifying articles into business and personal, travel, you know, into different categories for research later. But as soon as you've clicked on the web clipper, it's saved the article already. So now when we go into my Pocket list, we can see that I've got this brand new article that's just been clipped. And if I go in, I can read it here on my computer at any point in the future, even if my computer was, for whatever reason, offline. But that's not the real strength. The real strength is it is syncing through the web now to my mobile device. And I've got it set up on my smartphone. I've got the 6 Plus, the larger of the iPhones, which I find great for reading. And this is what I'm going to be reading these articles on when I'm traveling. Let's take a look at the account or the app. And when I open up the app, we see right away that it's already synced and it's already got this Google Analytics content on my account. So now I can read this whether I'm connected to the internet or not. And when we open the article, we see that it strips out all of the ancillary information around the sides and just basically gives you the meat of the article itself, allowing you to read it. And if there's rich media included, like in this particular case, the podcast, we can listen to it as well. So it gives us all of that rich content available to us to consume at our leisure. This is a powerful tool when it comes to being able to store and be able to access information that we want future reference to when we want it and when we need it. Now, the smartphone doesn't just work as a reader. Now, this doesn't have to be an iPhone. It could be an Android phone. It could be a tablet of some sort. It could be another notebook computer. But it doesn't just work as a reader. It also works as a research tool and collection tool. So, for example, I use the Pulse app to browse through the different Pulse articles that come from LinkedIn. And as I scroll through, I might find, oh, Apple says iPhone pre-orders are on pace. I'm not too interested in that. Google Car, not too interested in that. Oh, Li-Fi, how your LED LEST amp could help you connect to the internet. That sounds like an interesting article. I open that article. Again, I want to save that article. I don't necessarily want to read it right now. So what I do is I tap on the share tool and go share via. That brings up all of my different share options. And one of those options is to store it in Pocket. As soon as I tap on that, it now clips that article and it saves it to Pocket. So if I go back to my computer now and refresh my list, that new article from Pulse should be here. And there indeed we see that article from Pulse. And this doesn't just work for Pulse. This works for Zeit. This works for Flipboard. This works for dozens and dozens of different applications. So anything you can view in your browser, you can gain access to. But any information that you can view in a many, many other news-related or information-related apps, you can also clip for future reading. So now, my next business trip, I'm going to be that much more productive because I'm going to spend that downtime learning, increasing my skill set, increasing ideas, and just basically becoming a little bit better informed. I hope having watched this video today, you feel a little bit better informed. Now remember, there are three ways to stay in touch with us here on Dotto Tech. The first is please subscribe to this channel. Also, subscribe to our newsletter. That way you hear about all of our upcoming live events, including trainings, tutorials, and courses. And finally, Dotto Tech is a community-funded site. We're supported by the people who view our content here on the channel. So I encourage you to stop by our Patreon page and have a look at what patronage and Dotto Tech entails, because there are some perks, and I do believe the perks are awesome for both you and for I. Until next time, I'm Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle.